because when you guys like started having conversations, this thing started. That this whole mic thing started. And that's me being honest with you. Do you remember when you got your first strike?
No.
Because who were you talking to?
I feel like when I and Nenji discussed and also can never be discussing with Nenji without saying I feel like oh my god, I don't know what's wrong with Ozo. Sometimes I just feel like Ozo is just fun to watch. So please, can someone tell me in the comment section what Ozo means, like I feel like and the worst side of it is whenever he's discussing with Nenji, that is when he'll be talking like I feel like. He doesn't even want to say things straight to Nenji or even tell Nenji, I think this is what you are thinking, or Nenji, this is what I think you have done. Ozo will just be saying I feel like. Guys, this video is not that deep. So if you know you're Ozo's fan, don't take like I'm mocking Ozo or I'm trying to do something. I just want to crack jokes. Sometimes it's not all about, hi, this is Maram, I'm here, this. No, sometimes let's crack joke. Let's just laugh. Now, Nenji. The worst part side of Nenji is whenever Ozo is busy talking to Nenji about something that is very important to their life. As a couple, Nenji will come with like, also, I'm hungry. Also, let's go and eat. Also, are you not hungry? But yesterday, also just ignore her. And I was like, also, thank you. Well done. Well done. Then Nenji bad side is that side. Whenever also is talking something about love, Nenji will just distract the whole conversation and be talking like, I'm hungry. Oh, I want to go and do this. That means that she's not interested in the conversation. So guys, it's fun to watch anyway. Let's move on to Kidwire. Kidwire's side is whenever Kidwire is hungry, Kidwire will just be jumping from one fridge to another fridge. Or when he has already seen the eggs he's about to cook, Kidwire will be standing. He'll be standing like. Kidwire will be standing like somebody who is on a contest. In a contest of the best meal. I don't know. He'll just be so busy and serious about the cooking. Oh, Kidwire own. Sometimes I'll just be laughing, especially when Kidwire is preparing noodles. It's a fun to watch. Please be watching Kidwire when he's in the kitchen. Kidwire will just be so serious. For Neo, Neo own too is always in the kitchen. Neo will just be feeling like, I do know. I can cook. Neo always feels like I can cook more than anybody. He'll be using style. He'll just be mixing the food without stop. And V, on the other hand, V will be standing and looking at him. V will be telling him that I want to learn. So guys, this video is all about fun, please. No, nothing deep, okay? So these are the things I just observe in the house, and it just makes me feel like I want to laugh. Oh my god. Who's like this again? Who? Lekon! Lekon was trying to toast a bread one morning like that. You know, Lucy was the one who always cooked for Lekon. So that morning, Lucy was not forthcoming. Lekon was in the kitchen with the left hand. Picking the bread with the left. Using the spoon with the left. Everything with the left. Then later, he was not toasting. He toasted the bread. The bread was like, what? The bread was so dry and brownish because he over toasted the bread. He was now saying that, please, you guys should come and check. Oh, there's something wrong with this toaster. There's something wrong with this toaster. Dorati said that, you bloody fool. You bloody fool of that thing. Dorati is a vibe. Dorati is a vibe. That day, I just laughed. And then, and Lucy was inside the room telling him that, prepare breakfast for yourself. Practice make perfect. I was just like, Lucy, please go and help the guy now. Lucy, what is going on? Help him. Yeah. Lekon can't cook at all. I know. Maybe he's just mama pet. Whenever he needs food, mama will go and prepare food and give him. But he's really facing it in the house. And now that Lucy is not around, I really felt bad for him. Trickity, I haven't seen Trickity in the kitchen for once. Did Trickity cook anything in that kitchen? Please let me know in the comment section, because me, I haven't seen it. Even if I have seen it, maybe somebody is cooking. Trickity is there, busybody, waiting for his plate. I haven't seen Trickity cooking. Let me know in the comment section if it's not true, okay? Because for me, I haven't seen it, so I don't know for someone else. And Nengi, sometimes she will cook so nice, and she wants people to tell her that the food is nice. And there was a day she cooked jollof rice. Erika was trying to sabotage the jollof rice, but Kid, while I was busy eating and saying that the food is good. You know, he likes meat. Kid, while I can chew chicken wings. Oh my word. Kid, while I will be like somebody who is fighting with the chicken wings. You know all this adiabo. Erika was busy sabotaging the food. Like, Erika was saying that the pepper is too much, the salt is too much, but Kit Wire was not even listening to Erika. He was just saying, it's good, it's good, it's good. And that day, Erika just wanted to sabotage, but the food, I know it was nice, because most people finished their plate and then they told her that the food is nice, and she was all over asking everybody, is my food nice? Oh my God, who has liked this before I end this video? Now let's forge ahead with seriousness. Okay guys, now I'm gonna be serious, okay? Nothing like laughter anymore. I'm gonna tell you something. Donati had a discussion yesterday with her bestie Ozo. As usual, whenever Ozo is confused or Ozo is like lacking of what to do, Ozo will come back to Dorati and seek for advice as usual. So Ozo came and Ozo was telling Dorati that I don't know what's really happening. Guys, but let me ask you something before I continue. Why it is that Ozo cannot open his mouth and talk? Ozo will be talking like somebody who is talking to Nengi. You'll be hearing what Dorati is saying. Even when you increase the volume, you'll just be hearing Dorati's voice, but not Ozo. If you are not being careful and listening attentively, you will not hear what Ozo is saying. That's why Ozo is always having microphone infringement. Because Dorati was trying to tell him that, remember, you have already been warned by Big Brother and you're always doing it, and I don't want you to be having all this microphone infringement, and I don't also want to come and see you talking to someone and then you are not raising your voice up, and I'll be telling you also speak louder, it will feel like I'm trying to listen to your conversation, so I will never do that. And I have realized that the time you got close to Neo, that was when you started having this microphone infringement. Remember the serious warning from Big Brother? It was from Neo. You were discussing with Neo, and you see, you had an infringement. And most of the time, it's Neo. But this one yesterday, it was Nengi who was having rough play with Ozo. And then I think Ozo did not really wear his microphone that time, so Big Brother just gave him a microphone warning. Ozo is trying to learn bad habit, and which is not good, because if he doesn't want to be getting warning and strikes, he needs to be careful. And she said she did not know whether it's because of what Katina told her about Neo. That's why Neo is not her favorite housemate in the house. It's not like she doesn't like Neo, but it's just like she doesn't like Neo's vibe and sometimes the way Neo pretends. And you know, most of the time Neo will have this microphone on, but nobody will hear Neo microphone infringement. And Neo will be talking slowly and just whispering, but our Big Brother will never see it as Neo is not talking through the mic. I don't know how he does hide his mic, so Ozo should not be learning bad things. So Ozo was like, no, it's not about learning a bad thing. He said, no, you are learning a bad thing, because when you started talking to Neo all the time, your friendships getting closer all the time, that is when you started doing all this your microphone infringement. So you need to be very careful. I cannot be waking you up all the time to be telling you that, remember that you should speak louder. So I can't do that. Just try and avoid all these conversations. And most of the time, it's not like I don't have something to talk about. I do have, but I'm not like that kind of person who talks about people all the time. So I avoid it. It's not because I don't want questions on Sundays, but it's because I don't just want to interfere in somebody's life. So that's why I'm always being reserved. So typically me, I cannot come and be talking about someone and then I'm saying bad things about that person. At the end of the day, I cannot face the person and say it. So I rather avoid all these things than to be having microphone infringement. So that's why you haven't had Big Brother call me even for once. I remember Big Brother called me once, and then I think I was trying to do something, but Big Brother did not even complete his statement. So basically what Dorati is trying to say here is also to be mindful of the microphone infringement, because also it's like every 2 days or every 3 days, also we'll be getting microphone improvement. So now, guys, let's move on to should I call him Uncle Teriwaya or Daddy Teriwaya or Billionaire Teriwaya, anyone, okay? That is Kidwaya's father. I think he came with a strategy. Yes, he's trying to use Erica's fans to vote for Kidwaya, because if he can say that, okay, if Kidwaya wins, I'm gonna have the money, give half for charity and give another half to Erica. Why don't you give Erica now some money, now that she's outside and she have lost all her money she have won in that house? Because basically when you are disqualified, everything is terminated, you don't win anything, so everything will go in vain. So now that Erica has come out and Erica is out there looking for $100,000, why can't you just carry that $100,000 and give it to her, instead of saying that if Kidwaya wins, I'm gonna give her half? So I think what he is trying to do is to drag Erica's fans to Kidwaya, for them to vote for Kidwaya so that Kidwaya will win, and then audio money will come. Guys, if you know you are Erica's fan, I'm not saying that you should not vote for Kidwaya, but you all have seen the way Kidwaya treated Erica in that house, despite the fact that Kidwaya likes Erica, but maybe in a different way. But Erica's love was more than Kidwaya's own. It's even now that I see that Erica is not around, he's trying to fill Erica's absence. It doesn't make sense. When somebody is around, you don't show that love. When the person is normal, you are trying to show that love. It doesn't ginger me. It doesn't even pinch me. I don't even care about that. So basically, if you know you're Erica's fan, be careful of your votes. Vote anybody you want to vote for. Don't just vote because you think that Kidwaya's father will give Erica half of the money. It might be audio money after everything, and nothing can come out of it. So wise up and open your eyes. Yes. And some are saying that some people are there, they are giving Dorati endorsement, they are giving her 3 million, all those things now, audio. If you know you are Dorati's fan and you love Dorati and you want her to be safe, try and vote for her. Vote for her. Vote for her. I'm telling you guys, this is my instinct, and I'm telling you, you guys will vote for her. Vote for her, okay? Don't listen to anybody. She might have better chance to stay in the house more than any one of them down there. So you guys should just vote for her. Don't listen to anyone. Vote for her. Period. I don't have much to say about this. So listen to me and do. Okay? Now, also we can point is because the way he is trying to behave towards Nengi, trying to be Momo, trying to be a woman rapper. That's the reason why most men out there, they dislike Ozo. Even the girls who like Ozo, they are even trying to force themselves to like Ozo at this moment, because they are trying to feel like Ozo is being used by Nengi, and Ozo is not really focusing on the game because of Nengi. So Ozo could have done better in this relationship than following Nengi up and down, up and down. So now, if you know you are Ozo's fan, try and vote for Ozo. Vote for him, because it's gonna be tight. It's gonna be tight, very, very tight. So if you want to keep him in that house, you better vote for him. That's what I have to tell you. Kidwire's fans, I don't say that you guys should not vote for Kidwire because his father has money, but if you want to save him, vote for him, because last week Kidwire was off for possible eviction, and then he was among the least 8 bottom housemates. So please try and vote for him if you want to save him. And for Prince, people like Prince, but because Prince doesn't like Nengi and then Ozo, so the Igbo community, or some of the Igbo community, they are trying to dislike Prince because they are saying that Prince could have liked Ozo because they are from the same tribe. But remember, this is not about tribe. But I think that Prince's own is personal. Prince is not taking it because, okay, we are from the same tribe, I need to vote for them, or I'm not close to them. Prince is doing this because he has a grudge mind towards Nengi and Ozo, because Ozo is with somebody he likes in the house. So that is the problem why Prince is always calling Ozo Nengi all the time. They ask him for nomination. So basically, what I'm trying to say right now is Prince has lacked some fan base out there. The armies, I know they will vote for him, as they call him, the army group or the army team. But now that he is not really in for Nengi and Ozo, some of the people who are out there, they're trying to dislike him for that. We know that he's a jack of all trades, he does everything perfect, but he just needs to be very careful for disliking Nengi and then Ozo. So that's my advice. If you know you are in for Prince, you better vote for him and keep him in the house if you want to do so. Now let's move on to V. It's not a surprise to me that V is still in the house, because I know that V doesn't have fans as much as Dorati have, but
there's this kind of liking people have for V. They feel like V is intelligent and V is articulated, outspoken, and confident. So people are trying to keep her in the house because of that. So no doubt that she is still sitting down. So sometimes the people you underrate in the house are the ones who always go far into this game. For Neo, we all know the game he is playing, and that game has kept him in the house. Let me tell you this. Brighto said that Neo is a pretender, Neo talks too much, Neo brags. My dear brothers and sisters, I've seen this in Neo. Neo has a real game that he is playing, and Rati said that. And I also observed that from him. But it's very, very difficult for you to see the game Neo is playing if you are not really, really, really paying attention to him. Neo has tried to form alliance in the house to make so that everybody in the house will like him the way he is. So the personality he brought in the house is to be pretending. That might not be him, but when he comes outside the house, that is when you will see the real Neo. Right now, the real Neo is not him. It's not him. So when he comes outside, you will see the other side of Neo, because he has tried to make everybody to like him the way they see him. So that is the reason why he was not up for possible eviction. So this is my own analysis about this whole possible eviction on Sunday. So I just wish that I have helped someone out there to vote for their fans. And if I do so, please subscribe to my channel and don't hesitate to click on the notification bell. And when you do so, don't forget to give me a thumbs up whenever you watch my video. And I'm telling you guys that I'm signing out to see you guys in another video. So stay tuned and wait for my updates. But in a nutshell, I'm trying to say that shout out to all my Africans and diasporans. I love you guys so, so much. My love for you guys is priceless, and I'm not gonna stop loving you, but I'm gonna still continue loving you guys. Bye bye, and have fun for the day. Bye bye.